Right, well tonight, this is probably the final video on the mysterious weeping door that's going to fit on the downstairs loo in the house I'm helping to do up. And I think the last video I did of this door was when I had it over there and I was messing about with my scraper made from a saw blade. And I scraped it down the middle bar and there's all this weird brown sauce coming out of it. Well, I've done it again and this is now 2 or 3 weeks later and I've got more of this strange brown gunge coming out. But I'm ready to wax it now. And I don't think I can wax that because it's just... It's got this... I've scraped it all off about half an hour ago. I don't think I can wax it. I'm going to have to fit it in the house where it lives and leave it and just see what else it oozes out of it. But it seems to me that it's going to be never ending. There's always going to be this strange goo coming out of it. But anyway, I wanted to just do this video just to show what I do to these doors with this Briwax, which is fantastic stuff. 10 quid a tin, by and large, 11. And I use old pine because it gives it a lovely finish. This is how it looks, look. Kind of a quite a light beigey colour after it's come out of the pine strippers and been allowed to dry out. I've done the other side already with wax and given it a polish, and that's the finish that you get. And I love that finish. And you give it a... I apply it with a paintbrush. A lot of these self-help videos tell you to do it with a rag or with wire wool, and I find that a complete pain. It takes ages. Do it with a paintbrush, save yourself hours. Although it makes your paintbrush go a bit funny. That was a really nice quality paintbrush, and it's gone all... and you give... Anyway, you put this wax on, you give it an hour, and then you just buff it. Which is basically light strokes. You don't need to press hard, but you need to give it lots and lots of light strokes. Which I've already done anyway. But the more you give it, the better it becomes. And then you give it another coat and buff that after an hour. And the more coats you give it, the more beautiful, deep luster you get. That looks really nice. It's not hard. So, back to the problem side. It's got the weeping bit of wood in it. Let's just see if we can jam the camera up there. Yes, we can. So I'll just give it one more scrape. Look at that. Ugh. So I did it, what, an hour, maybe 2 hours ago. I scraped some gunge off and it still keeps coming back out. So that tells me I'm not going to wax that. I'll leave that. And maybe after 6 months or a year in the house with the central heating on, it'll start to dry out, but it certainly isn't drying out at the moment. So, just to show what I do, how I apply this Briwax. I always go with the grain. Just like here, look. If you go across the grain, it shows. So we always go with the grain.
I am assessing the situation. This is the strip that I've put on this edge, which is brand new wood, low quality because it's off an old packing pallet, but it will come out alright in the end. This is the patch I put on, which you wouldn't even know was there really. Now, this strange weeping goo seems to be coming out elsewhere as well. It's in there, look, and a little bit down there. So, goodness knows what it is. Right, I'm not going to do that bit. Although I've caught it a little bit there. First coat doesn't half suck in some wax. And the more coats you give, the less wax you use. Look at that, it's gone from a light beige to a nice deep, well not that deep, but mid deep hue already, before it's even been buffed. Buffing is the thing. I would definitely say probably three coats is the way to get the best finish. But as you can see, like here in this moulding, it's not going in very well. It's going in to a degree, but with each successive coat that you give it, you get a bit more coverage. Just a case of whether you can be bothered. Now look at that colour compared to that. That's just got such a nice deep Yeah, I've done that. Now this tin, which was £10.99 from Thoresby Home Care, and is 400 grams, with that, which is now nearly empty, with that I did the big front door on both sides at least twice. That's the big front door that I did with the big old copper coloured door closer in it. I did that one at least twice, maybe three times, don't do that. And I've done both sides of this for 11 quid. So I think that's good value. And it's Briwax, and the one I'm using to get this colour is Old Pine, which I think is the best we've found. We have used a clear one, clear wax for some things. I can't remember what we did it with actually, but that was quite good as well. So anyway, I'm not sure, I can't remember how long it takes before you should start to give it a polish, but blow it, I'm going to keep the video running. Have a little drinky, and then I'll buff it just to try and give an impression of how it goes from a matte finish to a nice kind of not gloss but a medium gloss luster when you give it a buffing, and that's what I love about it. Tomorrow I'm going to go to the house where it belongs and hang it. So I'm just doing this in a hurry really. Should have done it weeks ago, and I haven't got around to it. So I'm just doing this at 8 o'clock at night. And it's damp outside. And the big door's open behind me, so not gonna go off very quickly, but hey ho. The other thing I should do is, here's the nice old fashioned lock, which I've given a scrub up. It was covered in paint and gunge. So that'll go on there, that goes on the other side. And that turns the engaged / vacant dial. So I'm quite pleased with that, that's nice. So the thing about it is, it's so easy. The hardest part about it is being bothered. It is. Oh hell. Dee 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 d
Right, well here I am half an hour later, just giving it time to go off a little, and just going to give it a buff, and I'm not sure if it will show on the video, but I want to just see if it will show the difference between how it looks when the wax went on and how it looks after it has a bit of a buff. Just to see that shine that I can see down here, just see whether that appears on the video. And I can see down here all sorts of little imperfections just here. I haven't quite covered the wood there, and here, and here, and in here. But this is what happens. What you do is with each successive layer that you give it, it just fills in all the little bits that you've missed. And finish up with a lovely shine. And something very importantly is it's a lovely uniform shine. It's all down to layer upon layer. Definitely three times you need to do this. You've also got to look out for certain areas where you get too much on with a paintbrush, although I prefer it, you can actually get it a little bit heavily layered, such as here, look. If I scratch out on the nail, I've got too much on there, look. And you've got to, if you want perfection, well, you won't get perfection, but want it to look as really as nice as possible, just keep going at it. Look out for any bits where you've overdone the wax. Scrape them off or rub them off with your cloth.
revenge action. Yeah, lovely, lovely finish. So at the moment, I've no idea how that looks on the video, whether or not it's caught the nice shine. I'll know when I get to look at the video later. But from here, I'd be happy to hang that, and if I never got round to giving it another coat for a year or two, it wouldn't matter because it just looks so nice. And all it was one, how long did it take me? 10 minutes, 15 minutes? And 5 or 10 minutes to rub it. It's just so little effort for such a lot of reward. I love it. And then of course there's a little patch that I put in there, which although if you know it's there, you can see it. If you didn't know it, sir, you wouldn't even look at it. If you had a guest round and they walked into this door, they wouldn't go, oh look, an ugly patch. Just keep going and going and polishing and rubbing. You get a lovely, lovely finish. There's a bit where I've got it on too thick. I'll give it a bit of a harder rub rather than a buff, and that gets rid of it. Same up here, I've got it there, look. A bit too much there. Bit of a hard rub. It rubs it in, then a buff. There's my little patch, and here's my little lock, which I'm really quite taken with. That's quite fantastic when it gets screwed in. Need to find a door handle for there. But yeah. Look at that there, yeah, I can see it now. I can see the screen of the camera. And I can see the sheen on the door. Look at that, that's lovely. Right, that's it then. End of the weeping door with the patch. And the new bit on the edge. It's going to be fitted tomorrow with Lincoln. Fantastic.